In this video, I'm going to show you 10 ways that you can speed up Adobe After Effects so the software runs faster. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
The first way that you can speed up the software is to enable multi-frame rendering. To enable multi-frame rendering, what you can do is go up to After Effects, Settings, and then go to Memory and Performance. You'll see an option under Performance called Enable Multi-Frame Rendering. If this is available, be sure that it's checked on, so it's enabled. But when it's enabled, it'll utilize more of your cores in your CPU so that After Effects renders out faster. Another way that you can speed up After Effects is to dedicate more allocated memory to the software. So in that same panel up above, you'll notice that there's the memory section. And the big thing you want to keep in mind is how much RAM is preserved for other applications. Ideally, you want this number to be as low as possible. In my example, I have it set at 12 gigabytes, and I have 128 gigabytes of RAM installed on this computer. Now yours will look different, but try to keep this number as low as possible and dedicate more RAM to After Effects, Premiere Pro, and the other Adobe applications. This will make the software run faster. Another way you can make After Effects run faster is by turning on GPU acceleration. To do that, go up to File, Project Settings, and then under the first tab, you'll see the Use drop-down menu. If yours says Software Only and you have a GPU option, make sure that the GPU acceleration is checked. This will utilize your GPU rather than just the software. Another thing that can really help speed up After Effects is by working on an SSD or what's called a solid state drive. Now, ideally, if you're working on a project, I recommend just working right on your computer itself. It's the fastest type of hard drive that you can find. So for example, here, I'm working on a MacBook Pro. As you can see, I'm on my desktop. So all my After Effects files, all my client projects, my YouTube videos, they're all worked on directly on top of my desktop here. I'm not working on an external hard drive or different system here. Now, if working on your computer isn't an option, you can always use an external hard drive, but I recommend getting a fast one, an SSD. This is a Samsung T5, so you can get something similar to this. I'll leave it down in the video description if you do want to check out some external hard drives that I do recommend. Now, one other way that you can speed up your workflow is by changing where the cache is being stored at. Now for this, I do recommend saving it on an external hard drive. So if we go back up to our settings and we go to media and disk cache, you'll see that I currently have it saved directly on my computer. But what you can do is change this to choose folder and go to an external hard drive. When you click choose, you'll see that it changes to that folder on that hard drive. You can also change the settings under conform media cache. So I'm going to choose that folder once again and just move everything over there. You'll see this reflected in the Finder window. As you can see, I just moved all the cache files over there for After Effects. Now, another way you can speed up After Effects directly in your timeline is by changing the playback resolution. You can do this inside the composition window at the bottom left. You can change it from full to quarter. You'll notice that the resolution drops down quite a bit, but this enables you to preview your composition a lot quicker. Where when it's set to full, it takes After Effects longer. You'll notice some delays in scrubbing, but the caveat is that if you change it to quarter, you're seeing it at a lower resolution. Another option that you can choose is to turn on adaptive resolution. To do this, you can click on the lightning bolt icon in the bottom left-hand corner of the composition panel and change it from final quality to adaptive resolution. What this will do essentially is adapt the resolution as you move and adjust items inside your composition. This is very helpful if you're moving around different solids or objects and layers, or if you're working with masks. Now, sometimes in After Effects, you're working in a certain part of your composition. If you want After Effects to dedicate all of its rendering power into a specific spot, you can do that using region of interest. So for example here, maybe I'm working on this bottom center area. Maybe these two logos I need to work on. If I just want to focus in on this area, what you can do is select the region of interest button. As you can see, I already drew a region of interest, but if this isn't an option, what you can do is just click and draw out to draw a region of interest around a certain area. So as you can see, only this section is getting rendered out. And if we turn it off, the whole composition is getting rendered out. So this is a good way to just focus on certain areas of your composition. Now these options are great, but how do you know which layers are taking up the most time to render? There's a new feature inside After Effects that shows you exactly how long it takes each layer to render out one frame. If you navigate to the bottom left corner, you'll notice the snail icon. If you click on it, a new pane will open up called Render Time. This displays how long it takes for each layer to render out. For example, this logo layer here is taking 1 millisecond to render, where this black solid is taking up 85 milliseconds to render out. So this is a quick and easy way to see what's taking up the most render time inside your composition. And typically the reason why layers take longer than others is because of the effects applied to them. For example, here this black solid has Video Copilot's Saber effect applied to it with keyframed parameters. So this is obviously going to take quite a bit more time to render out rather than just being a simple logo on the screen. Now this is great, you know which layers take up the most time to render out, but how do you get around it? How do you make them render out faster? Well, one thing I recommend if you're working on a slower computer is, say if you get finished with some background elements or some different composites, to pre-render them out. Whether it's a video clip and you want to make proxies, you can make proxies of video clips, or if it's like a solid like this, I like just rendering it out and then re-importing it back into my project. So for example here, this black solid has the Saber effect plugin. If we go back into our project here, you can see I rendered this out as its own video clip. If we click and drag this into our composition, you'll notice that it takes a lot less time to render out. Now if you do want to do this for your own project, I do recommend checking out my video where I go over the best After Effects export settings. I will link that video right up there. Feel free to go watch that. But that does it for this video. That's 10 ways to speed up Adobe After Effects.